I'm just tryna run through the money, run. Yeah, I'm just tryna run through the money.
NatashaCastles.com. We in the building right now with Zoe Dollaz. It's hot in here.
Yeah, super hot.
To the bone dollars.
Yes.
Hey. Now we got the XXL freshman cover.
Yeah.
That's coming about. We got, you know, people voting. I saw your timeline blowing up with the votes.
Blowing up.
Who would you like to see on the cover with you? I know, you know, we got other
Denzel
Miami.
Curry.
Yep.
Denzel Curry for sure, for sure.
Miami in there.
Yeah. Anything, anything coming out of Miami.
What would you say about the music scene in Miami? I know I've read a couple articles. You know, you are working towards being the voice of Miami, the next voice of Miami. What would you say?
It's so diverse because you got people that's really popping, like Puya, and a lot of people don't know about him from Miami, but other places he's really lit.
Mm-hmm. What do you think it is in Miami? The support, local support is kind of...
It's just about what you make it.
Mm-hmm.
People have who they attend to. You know what I'm saying? Like,
how did it work out for you?
Man, it worked out for me because, one, I'm Haitian, and I grew up in a Hispanic neighborhood. So, mm-hmm.
They just bonded with the Latinos?
Yeah.
The Latinos?
They just rocking with me all the way.
That's dope. Now, I know you got the Diddy, nice little Diddy cosign.
Yeah.
What are conversations like with Diddy?
Funny as hell.
Like, I mean, the mogul talk, I can just imagine.
Just motivation.
What was your last conversation with him?
Just like a big brother just trying to downplay a little brother, that's all.
Trying to downplay you, like, are you ain't tight?
Are you trying to be like me? You can't outshine me.
What do you say back?
I'd be like, yeah, cool.
You should just watch me work.
I'd just be like, okay, yeah, all right.
Now, I know your mother played a big part in you recording your first record.
Super huge part.
What in your head, if you haven't already, what's the first big purchase you would want to make for her?
A house. I mean, I did that already, but like a mansion though.
Like a good house. What you think about, like 6-8 rooms?
About that.
About that.
So I could confiscate like 2 of them.
How much would you say your culture, you know, being from Haiti and whatnot, that has influenced your music?
It just makes me work hard because being from the island, we are natural born hard workers, period. So it just makes me always want to outwork everybody. And it's like, people be asking me why you don't seem excited. And it's like, I don't want to be excited. I'm still working.
Because you don't want to stop for gas.
Exactly. Like,
you got to keep going. You got to strike while the iron's hot.
I'm just going.
So what's next for Zoe Dollaz?
I mean, I just believe in just giving people music. That's what keeps you in.
Now, you talk a lot about, you know, having the relationship with Jim Jones and Diddy.
Yeah.
How has that helped you in the long run?
Jones just, he mentored me as far as making a lot of decisions in the streets and music-wise. He, like, was one of the first people who embraced me.
How'd you meet Jim?
I met Jim through like, my big bro, Lucci. Huh. And then ever since then, he became, like, family to me. Like, he come to my house, I go to his house. That's like blood couldn't even make us, you know? That's like my big bro, for real, for real.
That's ill. So, I mean, you have the album out right now.
Yeah.
What's Who next don't like for Dollaz?
I'm about to drop again in May.
Another one that was
Another
not on
one.
Purpose.
But it's like, I got a surprise, though, because it's really what's supposed to be Success and Enemies, but... We just decided to briefly change the name, the title.
Of the album?
Yeah, and I think people going to be more like, wow.
Like, susceptible to it? Why the title change?
A good friend of mine in the industry, I was on the phone with him.
The timing and everything?
I sent him my cover, and then he called me back. He said, so that's it? I'm like...
Like he was unimpressed?
Not that he wasn't unimpressed. He felt like it should be my actual... first major album title instead of it being a mixtape or an EP.
Mm-hmm.
So he was like, I think you should name it that. And he gave me the name and I'm like, oh crap. That's the name.
That's it.
And then we just gonna go.
So in this album, what can we expect as far as like just what the concept is from beginning to end? Any features?
I have a whole lot of features. I feel like this album is It's just more, I think I do more street music in this, more clubbing, because my previous work, previous project, I tried to keep it more like personal storytelling and 90s feel. I didn't really attend to the club much. I probably had one club, but this one, like, we going to the club in this one.
Did you find yourself doing that on purpose, or is it that, like, you know, stuff that just came to organically?
Since I couldn't put everything in one album, because nowadays it don't make sense you dropping something with 16 tracks. It's like, ain't nobody listening to that.
Short and simple.
Exactly. I just had so much music, I just break it down. Like, my next thing might just be not for the club, motivational stuff only. And the following might just be about girls only. The following might be about heartbreaks.
It's kind of just what happens.
It's just stories. To be continued thing. That's what I try to do.
I like that. Now, you said you have a whole lot of futures. Do you get to share any of that with me right now?
I got Future on there. I got Fab. I got Ross. I got Jim Jones. I got French Montana. And I got Lil Durk. I got quite a few people. And I got Lil James from TMT. I got
How did some of these collaborations come about?
Just some people in the game that I rock with on like, I feel like I'm cool with them. Because I try not to be cool with everybody in the game, because they weirdos.
It can get weird out there.
Yeah, they weirdos.
When you finally, like, get to meet some people, you're just like
people you grew up watching, like, damn, it's my favorite. When you meet them, they're, like, extra weird. And it's like, what?
Is there somebody that you had to have, or like you kind of reached out to on your own and kind of like, yo, I need, I'm a big fan?
I mean, none that could come to the top of my head right now, but a lot of them, I don't know if it's the money or whatever it is, because sometimes chasing this fame kind of make you like heartless and weird. And but I'm from the streets and I'm still in the streets, so it's kind of like when people do weird stuff, to me, I just be looking at it's so. It's like, it's different to me when you do weird stuff, because I'm really a street dude and I'm looking at you like, hell is you doing? Like,
what's a whole different world?
Yeah, it's two different worlds.
So what's going to happen when you get to that world?
I mean, I'm in it now.
Uh-huh.
It's just, I remain me. I remain myself, and that's what makes me different, because people don't know how to be themselves. So once you remain yourself, it's just, money don't do nothing but just make you live comfortable.
That's all it does. And you're right.
And that's what I'm in it for. I just want me to live comfortable, my friends to be cool, my family to be straight.
Do what you do.
Yeah, I don't really like...
not giving into overly, any gimmicks or...
Yeah, it's like whatever it takes to make my family straight and my friends straight, that's all I go for. I don't want to change and turn into a weirdo and doing weird stuff.
What's the weirdo part? Like, what would you describe as a weirdo?
I mean, we on air, so I can't really, like...
Not who, but what? Like, what, like, characteristics?
No, I could say who
say.
If oh, it okay. was to say who. It's just... It's just, like, people be... They be weird. They don't be like, trill like they say they are. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? You meet them, and they just be... They don't got no soul in them. They just so,
They're just, it's all business, it's all work.
Not even business, because I don't even want to do business with no weirdos like that. I just be trying to like, all right, cool. Sometimes I don't even be wanting to like, my friends be like, yo, let's go meet so-and-so, they in the club. I be like, I'm cool, bro.
For what?
For what? Like, we chilling. He hot, I'm hot too. He on the radio, I'm on the radio too. He in Club in America, so am I.
No extra bougie yet.
Yeah, they don't be humble. That be the I'm so humble.
That's what it is. It's the humble thing.
I'm so humble that it's like I could leave my section and walk by myself and go say what's up to you, but they wouldn't do the same. So it'd be like, whatever.
It feels like you're like going out of your way to do stuff instead of like an organic like, hey, what's up? Like, you know.
And they be finicky, and I'm authentic. I don't be with that. Like, I see people as people. I think I'll only be starstruck if I see Jay-Z. That's my favorite
the
rapper.
The only one?
The only person I'll ever be like,
and you
oh
haven't
my
had the
God.
Opportunity. I did see you tweet today that like, you would like a Rock Nation.
Super.
Nice little chain
there.
I'm
still going to get one.
Still going
to
get one?
I'm going to use my own money to get one. Like, that's like my dream. So it's like, that. I think only Jay-Z. I look at other rappers as just like, you just talented as I am, and you put in work and you got what you deserve. I don't look at them like this. Stuff, you know, I'm still a
like
fan.
Like higher than, because we're all putting in work.
I'm a fan of
got the hustle.
Almost everybody in the game. Everybody. There's nobody in the game right now that can say, oh, I don't like him. Like
their style.
Might
or
not
anything.
Like their attitude while listening to their music, though.
You know, you're right. Yeah. That's one thing I can definitely admire from anybody, even if it's not, I don't admire them as a person, is hustle.
Definitely. I like everybody. I love Young Thug. I love Future. I love Drake, Meek Mill.
Everything
everybody.
They're putting out.
Yeah. I like everybody. I can listen to these people for. Jay-Z, my favorite rapper. Sometimes I listen to Young Thug more than him.
I mean, just because you like one genre or like one type of, you know, hip-hop direction doesn't mean you can't. That's what I don't like is, you know, you get judged off of like, oh, that's what
because
you listen
sometimes
to.
Sometimes I make music and I'm like, man, I want this to sound like Thug. Or, man, I want this to sound like Drake.
Is it hard to, or when you say you want it to sound like them,
like the type of song that I know if they would jump on.
Yeah.
You know what
okay.
I'm saying?
So we're going to have to put that out there in the future. Put it out in the universe. Have it happen organically.
It's in the works, you know? Not nothing I'm looking forward to because, like, I could do it on my own, too, at the same time. I don't really need no Thug or no Drake, but it'll be dope, though. You know what I'm saying?
Oh, yeah.
Be super dope.
Well, I'm looking forward to the album this May. Memorial Day weekend. We don't know the name.
Yeah.
When will we know the name? And the cover and all that good stuff.
I'm just going to put it up.
We're going to put it up. He's going to surprise us.
Mm-hmm.
Drop it. And that's a dope thing. What was that? I mean, even though I don't know what the cover is there any concept to it or just wait for it?
My culture.
So we got some Haitian culture in it.
Yeah, deep.
For sure. Deep.
Deep Haitian culture.
All right, that's dope. I'm looking forward to it. Okay, Zoe Dallas, Vote For Him, Double XL, freshman cover, 2016. You're going to Natasha
Please
Castle's
do.
Live 101.5.
Go vote for your boy.